Apart from the dimensions and texts, we can also insert leaders to explain what each part of our drawing indicates. In this example, the 2D views of the parts of a pulley support have been created. To get a better picture of the objects that are depicted in the views, an image of the 3D object is shown. These are all parts of a pulley support. If we assemble those parts, a pulley support is being created. Back to the drawing, I will insert leaders with the name of each part as was shown in the image. To insert a leader, I can open the dimension menu and select the multileader option. Or I can go to the home ribbon and select the leader option from the annotation panel. The first part is the pulley. I have to specify the leader arrowhead location first, so I will open the nearest object snap, and then I will click somewhere on the front view of the pulley to place the arrow. Next, I will specify the leader line by clicking on the left. In the last step, I have to specify the leader's content, so I will type the word pulley. Notice that the text editor ribbon appeared, so I can modify the text if I need to. Once I make the changes I want, I will click on the Close Text Editor button to finish the leader's creation. Then I will reactivate the leader tool and proceed to insert the second leader to the next part, which is the bushing. I will click on the external circle of the front view to place the arrow, then click to specify the leader line, and finally I will type the word bushing and close the text editor to insert this leader too. I will continue inserting leaders to the rest of the parts in the same way. The last two parts are both nuts. So once I insert the leader of the first nut, I will open the leaders option list and I will select the Add Leader option. I will select the leader of the nut and notice that another leader with an arrowhead appears. Both leaders are connected to the word nut. I will click on the top view of the second nut to place it. To change the position of the leader, I will select it and click on the grips. I can adjust its position by moving the cursor accordingly. When I'm satisfied, I will click again to place the leader to the new position. There are several grips I can use to adjust each part of the leader just by clicking on them and moving them to a new position. To remove the second leader, I will reopen the leaders option list and select the Remove Leaders option. Then I will select the multi-leader I previously created and I will press Enter. The second leader was removed automatically. I will click on the Undo button to restore the multi-leader and move on to show you how to modify the leader styles. First, I will open the Multi-Leader Style Manager window. I can open this window if I expand the Format menu or if I expand the annotation panel of the Home ribbon and click on the Multi-Leader Style icon. Either way, the window with all the available styles appears. I will select the standard style, which is the one that was used, and click on the Modify button. In the first tab, I can change the leader type from straight to spline. I can even remove the leader line if I want to. In this example, I will select the spline. Now look how the preview changed! Right below, there are three fields that also have to do with the leader: the color field, the line type field, and the line weight field. I can change the leader's color, line type, and the line's thickness if I want to. However, in this case, I will only change the color to cyan. Next, I will change the arrowhead symbol from the list. I will select the open arrow and change its size to 2.5 from the size field below. Then I will move to the Content tab to make some changes to the text. First and foremost, I will change the text color to cyan, and then the text size to 3. I can add a frame around the text by activating the Frame Text checkbox. I can also change the text angle if I wish, but in this example I will not do it. Another important field is the landing gap, which defines the distance between the text and the leader line. I will set this value to 1 and then I will look in the preview. Once I'm satisfied with the result, I will click OK to close this window, and I will also close the Multileader Style Manager window. At this point, I will select all the leaders and delete them in order to replace them with the new type of leaders I have created. As I mentioned in the beginning of the lesson, those are the parts of an assembly. Each part in assemblies is represented by a different number as is shown in the image. To insert balloon leaders like the ones in the image, I will expand the annotation panel of the Home ribbon and open the drop-down menu of the leader styles. From the available styles, I will select the balloon style. Next, I will open the Multileader Style Manager window, select the balloon leader style, and click on Modify. I can change the multileader type from the Content tab to Block. If I expand the drop-down list of the Source Block field, I can find a variety of blocks and shapes such as slots, hexagons, and circles. From the available options, I will select the circle and then I will click OK. I will also close the Multileader Style Manager window and proceed to insert the first balloon leader. The first part is the pulley, which is the item number 2, so I will activate the leader tool and click to place the arrowhead. Once I click to place the leader line, the Edit Attributes window appears automatically. I will type the number 2 in the Enter Tag Number field and click OK. Notice that a bubble leader with a number 2 in it was created. In the same way, I will insert the rest of the leaders one by one. In case I want to change the number of a leader, all I have to do is double-click on it and the Edit Attributes window will reappear. I can change the number of the tag and click OK. The number changed automatically and now the leaders have been placed right.